Welcome to Engineering Python. This is a Python programming course for engineers. In this video, I will talk about the random library. The random library contains some simple functions that can generate random numbers. These random numbers can come from the uniform, normal or Gaussian, log normal, negative exponential, gamma, and beta distributions. We need to import the random library before we use these functions. Some of the functions generate random integer numbers, others generate random float numbers. We will talk about functions for integer numbers first. This is the randrange function. The syntax of the randrange function is very similar to the range function we talked about in a previous video. It returns a randomly selected element from this range that includes the start but does not include the end. We can also change the steps. Let's see some examples. Randrange 5. This statement returns a random integer from these five numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. In this case, it's 0. Run it again. This time, the return is 3. Again, the return is 4. Over time, this function will produce a uniform distribution. Each number in this range will appear an approximately equal number of times. The randrange function with a start 11 and an end 15 will return a random integer from these four numbers 11, 12, 13, and 14. In this case, it's 11. Run it again, this time the return is 12. Again, the return is 14. The randrange with a start negative 10 and end 0 and a step 3 returns a random integer from these four numbers negative 10, negative 7, negative 4, and negative 1. Run it. The return is negative 7. Run it again, negative 4. The third time, negative 10. The randint function with parameter a and b returns a random integer number between a and b, including both a and b. In this example, the start is negative 2, the end is 2. It returns a random integer from these five numbers. It is equivalent to randrange with a start negative 2 and an end positive 3. Run it three times. The returned values are 0, negative 1, and positive 2. Now let's see some functions for float numbers. This may seem strange, but it is a legal statement in Python. It is a random function in the random library. It returns a random float number uniformly distributed between 0 and 1, including 0, but not including 1. Run it for the first time, it generates 0.68. Run it again, it is about 0.73. The third time, about 0.06. The uniform function returns a random float number uniformly distributed between A and B, including A but not including B. For example, this uniform function will return a number between 2.5 and 5, including 2.5, but not including 5. Run it for the first time, it returns 4.3. The second time, it's 2.5. The third time, it's 3.3. There are many other commonly used random functions that generate random float numbers. They include the triangle function, the beta variate function, the expo variate function, etc. You can find their documentation by following this link. The shuffle function operates on a sequence X, which is a list. It shuffles its contents in place. That means X will be updated after the shuffle operation. For example, X is this list, 1, 2, and 3. After shuffling, it is changed to 3, 1, 2. Shuffle it again, now it's 1, 3, and 2. I need to mention that the numbers generated by these functions are pseudo-random numbers. They appear to be random, but actually not. They are generated by an entirely deterministic process using different seeds. By default, Python uses the current computer state and time as a seed. So when a random function is revoked a second time, it is using a different seed, and thus a different number is generated. By reusing the same seed value, the same random number can be reproduced. Sometimes it is useful to reproduce the random numbers for verification purposes. Let's see some example. We set the seed to be 1001 using the seed function. Then we generate a random number between 0 and 1 using the random function. It is 0.79. Let's execute the same statements again. The seed is still 1001. As a result, the same random number 0.79 is generated. Let's change the seed to 1002. This time, the generated number is 0.52. If we don't use a seed, Python will use the computer's time as a seed. It generates a number 0.42. Run it again. Because the time is different, a few seconds has passed. It generates 0.22. Okay, that was all about the random library. The course materials are available on YouTube and GitHub. You can watch the course videos in sequence. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. I'm Yong Wang. Thanks for watching.